Hi, welcome to this demo of Labshock. Labshock is a virtual lab for learning OT security. You can simulate ICS networks, deploy virtual PLCs, SCADA systems, and test attack and defense scenarios, all on your own machine. In this video, I'll walk you through what Labshock looks like, how it works, and what you can do with it. It's made for anyone curious about ICS security, from students to professionals. Let's dive in and see it in action. Now, let's talk about the services. The PLC service in Labshock includes OpenPLC. You can access the web interface where you can manage the PLC. You can start or stop it, checking if it's running and view its status. You can also view logs. In the program section, you can upload or update programs. The monitoring page shows tech statuses and their values. In settings, you can enable or disable communication protocols and adjust basic and security configuration. Labshock also includes SCADA. This is a fully functional SCADA system where you can design your own layouts. Here, we've created one for an oil station called Oil Spring. You can switch pumps on and off, monitor data, configure objects with different tags, values, and colors, and assign actions or events to them. In settings, you can link the SCADA to a PLC. Using protocols like OPC UA or Modbus. Here, we have connected using Modbus with IP address and port. And a list of tags from the PLC, such as pump and valves data. You can map different coils and registers via Modbus. There is also an alarm section where you can acknowledge alerts like in a real SCADA system. Next, we have the engineering workstation. Which includes all necessary tools pre-installed. You can connect to SCADA, PLC, or program the OpenPLC using the editor. You'll also find example projects to load, modify, and learn how to define tags with various data types and values. It supports multiple programming languages, from structured text to ladder logic. You can monitor your program in real time and observe tech data. you can compile and upload a program directly to the OpenPLC. Next is the IDEA service called Network Swiftness. It allows you to inspect traffic between PLC and SCADA and other sources. Using a clean web interface, you can detect and filter specific actions, such as coil writes or read operations on the registers and inputs. You can see the protocols used, IP addresses involved, and view all communication between devices. There is also a connections tab to track IPs and protocols used in communications. Next is the log collector. It gathers logs from PLC, SCADA, and engineering workstation, and can send them to the SIEM. For example, here you can see login attempts and PLC actions like start-stop. Now, let's try entering an incorrect username and password. The PLC responds with an error, bad credentials. The collector received these logs in real time, showing a failed login attempt. Another service is Pentestation. It's a pre-installed Kali Linux machine. You can use it to run tools, simulate attacks, test scripts, and learn offensive techniques. Let's log in into the Pentestation. Username Pentest, password Pentest. Let's check, for example, nmap, which is pre-installed. We'll scan the PLC with IP address 2.10 on the first 10,000 ports. As you can see, Modbus is open and an HTTP server is running. We can confirm these by checking traffic in Network Swiftness. It shows someone trying to connect to the PLC with different ports. That was a quick demo of Labshock. If you want to try it out, check the link in the description. It's free and easy. You also find documentation, a Discord server, and more labs coming soon. If this was helpful, leave a like or comment. And if you want more content like this, subscribe and put star on GitHub. Thanks for watching. Zahar, the creator of the Labshock.